This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about finding the domain of a composition of functions. So here's the first example. I've got these two functions, f of x equals x squared, and g of x equals the square root of x minus 4. And let's say I'm told to find f compose g of x and state the domain of that composition. Now remember, when we have the domain of a function, what we're basically asking is, what values of x can I have which will allow the function to produce some result? In other words, what values of x can I place into the function? So the question here would be, when I find out what f compose g is, could I have f compose g of 7? Could I have f compose g of 0? Could I have f compose g of negative 10? Okay, so let's first convert this f compose g of x into a simpler form. We're going to make it into f of g of x. And that's going to let us replace the g of x with what g of x equals, which is the square root of x minus 4. So now I've got f of the square root of x minus 4. So let's see. Our f function says that f of x equals x squared. So f of the square root of x minus 4 would equal the square root of x minus 4 squared. Now, whenever we square a square root, we get whatever was underneath the radical sign. In other words, this thing just equals x minus 4. So it looks like f compose g of x is going to equal x minus 4. So if I want to know what the domain of this new composed function is, I would just ask myself, are there any numbers which x could not be? And it seems fairly simple that x could be just about any number I want. It could be a positive number or a negative number. It could be 0. But it's not quite that simple. Even though the composition, this final result, seems to show that x could be any real number from negative infinity to positive infinity, we have to think of its parts. Especially, we have to think of what I'm calling the inside function of this composition, that g of x. If we look at g of x equals the square root of x minus 4, and I can't use just any number for x. After all, if x was, let's say, 0, then the square root of 0 minus 4 would be the square root of negative 4, and I can't take the square root of a negative number. So what I want to do is take this g of x function and find out what x could be, find out what its domain would be. So down here, let's take this x minus 4 and realize that that's got to be either greater than or equal to 0. I can take the square root of 0, I can take the square root of a positive number, but not a negative number. So to solve this inequality, I'll just add 4 to both sides. I'm going to have x is greater than or equal to 4. So the domain for this composition, f of g of x equals x minus 4, is going to be restricted. It's going to be x has to be greater than or equal to 4. Okay? So when we're looking for the domain, we're doing two things. We're finding the composition and seeing if there are any restrictions on that composition. In this case, there weren't. We're also looking at the individual functions, specifically the inside function, the g in this case, and see what the restrictions on its domain are. We had restrictions there. And so the restriction for the whole composition is going to be, in this case, that x has to be greater than or equal to 4. Okay? Let's take a quick look at another one. Okay, so in this case, I've got f of x equals the square root of x, and g of x equals 3x plus 2. And once again, Let's do F compose G of X. Find out what that composition is and what the restrictions are going to be. So I'll turn this into F of G of X. Since I know what G of X is, 3X plus 2, I'll rewrite this as just F of 3x plus 2. And then my f function says take the square root of that. So that's going to be the square root of 3x plus 2. So f compose g of x is equal to the square root of 3x plus 2. Okay. Well, I've got a square root here, so there are going to be restrictions on this. 3x plus 2 is going to have to be greater or equal to 0. So let's work that out. 3x plus 2 is greater than or equal to 0. I subtract 2 from both sides, so I'm going to have 3x is greater than or equal to negative 2. Now I just divide both sides of that inequality by 3. And I get x has to be greater than or equal to negative 2/3. So x is greater than or equal to negative 2/3. Now before I stop, let's go back to that g of x function and make sure there are no restrictions there. Well, the g of x function was just 3x plus 2. And since x could be any number here, it could be a positive number, could be 0, it could be a negative number, the g of x part of this is not going to add any more restrictions. So now I can state that f compose g of x equals the square root of 3x plus 2, and x has to be greater than or equal to negative 2/3. Okay? So when you're taking care of this, when you're doing the domain of a composition of functions, make sure you look for two things. One is, what's the domain of the final composition? And as we saw in this other problem, what's the domain of the inside function, the function that we deal with first? In this case, it was the g of x function. Okay, so that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.